can you just take a very, very high end down and you can come above and say 10K?
We became, you know, lots of stories, and it's just, those are our salad days in our 20s. It's just really good times, and Victor's been a great friend ever since. I just always felt really close with him, and, you know, they opened for Savage Republic on that tour at Santa Cruz at the Culture Club, and they didn't pay us. There was like five bands, and when we went to get paid, the guy flashed his gun because they were like money laundering, cocaine money.
Yeah, Reggie. Yeah, Greg's girlfriend went out with Reggie that
promotion. So it was a giant show. Back then, we went to shows. It was like hundreds of people and no money. And then we played at the MAM the next night. So it's just like really good times. And so I'm just really happy to have Victor here at this How to Destroy the Universe Festival on my 16th birthday, so that was over 40 years ago. This is an intimate show, so anyone in the back, feel free to come up here and gather around the LED campfire.
It's all good. This is an older type of music. Acoustic music in churches, I think, have a long relationship, although I guess technically we're not
really
acoustic. We're kind of half of that. Faux acoustic. Alright, so we're gonna. I've been. Camper and Beethoven, Greg and I have a band, or had, I don't know, I guess it's still a band, Monks of Doom. I've done solo stuff for years with this cast, the Terra Prism, and a few others. I'm playing a band with Dave Alvin called The Third Mind. What else have I done? I'm in a band with Peter Buck called Lyds. I've known Ethan for years. It seemed like a nice chance. We haven't, because of COVID and me living in Portland now, we haven't been able to do this in a while. And it just seemed like, wow, like punk rock bands and DJs and industrial stuff, why not some acoustic folk music? It seems like we could actually punk rock that. So let us punk rock.
Now if I could
Thank you.
that card, I couldn't get you on the line. Oh, nothing matters now that it's over. There's no getting right through to you. I tried to call you, I couldn't get you on the line.
I
contest. Big man, I need you more. Ask me above the mess. Soaring through outer space. There is no better place to be.
Coming up on 40 years. All right, let's not curse ourselves. This is a song called Head for the Hills. We've never played this together. Well, Brayden and I have played this before. That's cool. That's going to be great. Seat of our pants. Paul Gino on the bass guitar. People tell me I'm a good bass player. I always point to him and say, "I'm it." He's all right. I like Paul.
Me too.
All right. Now that we've complimented ourselves, expand on. Let's do Artists in Trouble.
Yeah.
Because that's.
This is a song about my late friend Joe Burns, who had a bad end in the Mission District. And in the course of that bad end, we were hanging out one night and we went over, what's the church over by you? Immaculate Conception. They thought, I forget what year this was, maybe 2010. They thought they could see the Virgin Mary in the side of the church, and it turned into kind of a citywide thing where people were coming over and trying to see this faded image of the Virgin in the wall. And I went over there with Joe, and I was like, I don't see it. I was like, I see it, which should give you some idea. Joe's state of mind. Joe's been gone for a while now.
Thank you.
inexplicably. It's hot and still, it's earthquake weather. I got a feeling I just can't change. The bad news hit me like a sucker punch. I keep thinking about those things. Most of the time, I'm glad I moved on. But sometimes, I want your mind to change.
Thank you.
couldn't do another thing for you. I'd done all I could.
Song's called The Cock Crows at Sunrise.
goes out to my father, who was alternately a wonderful human being and a snake at the same time.
Bye.
very much. We really appreciate that.
That was fucking awesome, guys. Service too.